Actually, right? And also, please give it up for your host, Juan Gurriel. Amazing guy. Where are the Mexicans in the house tonight? Right? You're Mexican, bro? Right? I can tell. As soon as I saw you, I can tell. He's the most Mexican guy I've ever seen in my life. He's so Mexican, he probably says provecho before he eats pussy. Right? Provecho or provechito? Provechito. Got it. Spanish is hard, man, and that's why I'm doing this in English. Spanish is hard. There's so many different accents. There's so many different Mexicanisms that are involved, right? So when I first started learning Spanish, I learned it from a niña fresa, right? So I was like, oli. La cuenta por fees. Alguien tiene servilletas. And all my male friends were like, todavía más como un pendejo, güey. I was like, that's how I learned it. What do you want me to say, right? And then eventually, my male friends told me like, hey, real Mexican men, when they speak Spanish, they're like saying a lot of bad words, you know? Chingada, mamada, llamada, all the das that you can think of. So I was like, okay, all right. And then I was like, I get into a fight. So I'm like, now's my time to speak like a real Mexican man. And I was like, ¿alguien quiere tirar vergasos? Fun fact, I actually won that fight because the other guy couldn't stop laughing. So have you guys heard of this thing called the Tesla bot? Yeah. No? Essentially, Tesla invented this new robot. Yeah, you know what I mean exactly. Invented a new robot that essentially is like going to be put in every house to help you with like chores and stuff like that. Right? Fucking Black Mirror shit. Yeah.
Yes.
What I want to see is that Tesla bot in a Mexican household. Can you imagine being the first ever robot that gets the chancla? She's screaming after him, pinche Arturito, right? And then the passive aggressive, mean shit talk from the mom, pues, no hay nadie para ayudarme en esta casa. Just starts committing suicide because you can't take it anymore, right? Well, I was born in India, right? And being a brown guy, you know, when you go to the US, it sucks. For 5 words, you know, randomly selected for additional screening. That sucks. But it's even worse when you're a brown guy coming to the US from Mexico. Because I remember, and this will never leave my mind, I remember when essentially I give my passport to the TSA guy, and he's like, holy shit, oh my god. It's finally happening. ISIS and El Chapo are finally working together. Relax, baby. Thank you. Before I go, I just wanted to make one more quick joke. One of the things about Mexico that I love is that, you know, there's a lot of Mexicanisms, right? Like, you guys don't, there's a Chilango accent, which also makes it very difficult for me to understand Spanish, right? Because you guys say stuff that I have to Google Translate, and it doesn't make any fucking sense, right? For example, thank you for asking me, for example, right? What is the Mexican Spanish, or the Chilango Spanish word for, o sea, right? O sea, estoy cruda, o sea, right? I have to Google Translate that. So, o sea, in Spanish means female bear. So she's hungover. But there's a female bear somewhere, right? But my favorite is, what is the Chilango word for, I guess, right? Poisi, right? But Chilangos don't say that. They say, pussy. Pussy! I thought this was a very manly, yeah, you know, very patriotic, almost like, yeah, everybody's just calling each other pussy all day. Right? I remember my first day at work, we were at a meeting, and this particular gentleman was asked by my boss, like, hey, do you have the report? And he just goes, pussy. I said, did you just call the boss a pussy? And then the boss just goes like, okay. That's my time, everybody. Thank you so much. Please give it up.